Lasers are a common feature of our lives today, from the grocery store checkout to the dermatologist's office to the printer in your workplace. But did you know that the word laser actually stands for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation? And they've only been around since 1960. That makes this year, 2020, the 60th anniversary of the invention of the laser. In the six decades since Theodore Maiman developed the first working laser, laser technology has become an essential part not only of our everyday lives, but also of advancing science, technology, and medicine of all kinds. To celebrate this momentous year, let's go through six of the most important developments throughout the last 60 years of lasers and how the lab has shaped laser technology as we know it today. In 1961, just 1 year after the laser was first invented, we have the first medical use of a laser. It was used to destroy a retinal tumor, and since then, lasers have gone on to become key tools for many kinds of surgery, especially eye surgeries. In the 1980s, eventual Nobel Prize winner Donna Strickland developed chirped pulse amplification, or CPA, which is the technology behind many laser breakthroughs, including modern eye surgery techniques. Some other laser advancements at the lab also eventually made their way into medical applications, like the LLNL advancement of tunable dye lasers. This impacted the ability of doctors to be able to treat conditions like port wine stains with lasers. Our second landmark advancement has a pretty fun acronym. It's called the Master Oscillator Power Amplifier, or MOPA. The development of MOPA laser systems allowed us to come up with new ways to amplify a laser's power by, if we're putting it very simply, basically just bouncing it through different pieces of glass or other materials that can amplify the power of a laser's light. This is called optical amplification, and it's important because it means you can not only make your laser more energetic, but it also allows you more control over things like wavelength, beam quality, intensity, and phase. So basically, MOPAs allow scientists to have bigger lasers with more detailed control, which is a great combination. Livermore put MOPAs to work right away, building a series of increasingly larger lasers, each even more powerful than its predecessor. And think about it, the larger and more powerful the laser, the more realms of physics we can potentially unlock. That series of laser facilities at Livermore brings us all the way to 1995, when Livermore's Nova laser facility achieved a peak power output of 1 petawatt. To put that into context, a typical power plant delivers around 1 to 2 gigawatts. So laser power at the petawatt level exceeds the power release of literally any other human-made object, and that includes the detonation of nuclear weapons. The petawatt capability of Nova inspired other petawatt laser facilities around the world, and that 1995 achievement is actually still more powerful than many of the lasers that are being built right now. These petawatt laser systems are useful for lots of exciting research, like the acceleration of protons for cancer therapeutics, or the production of electron beams that match the energies found in modern particle accelerators. The Nova petawatt capability brought about an entirely new field of what we call high-intensity, short-pulse laser physics. And this area of laser physics is making advancements in developing novel tools for creating, probing, and measuring the hottest and densest matter on Earth. Plus, they let us generate quantum electrodynamic and astrophysical phenomena that without those lasers would otherwise be totally inaccessible to us. Then, in 2009, LLNL completed the most energetic laser facility that has ever been built, the National Ignition Facility, or NIF. NIF just celebrated its 10th birthday, and we have a whole video on its history and the science we do there that you can watch here. But it's safe to say that NIF has taken science and technology to a whole new level. NIF helps us understand more about nuclear fusion, plasma physics, the insides of stars and planets, and other questions about the nature of our universe. Not only did NIF enable the development of unprecedented laser technology, but it also spurred major developments in everything that surrounds the laser. I mean, if you're gonna build the biggest laser, you're also gonna need more glass and more power than you've ever needed before. So building NIF also meant making entirely brand new kinds of optics, diagnostics, and computing. NIF is currently the only facility in the world that reaches these temperatures and densities, allowing researchers across the globe to unlock previously unknown and untouched realms of not only laser physics, but also all of the fields that make laser physics like this possible. Now, NIF has let us do some truly awesome stuff in the past 10 years, including a recent development. NIF fired 2.15 megajoules into its target chamber in the summer of 2018. That's more than any laser system ever. Again, this wouldn't have been possible if other science and technology at the lab hadn't also been pushing boundaries, like optics development. See, NIF uses tens of thousands of large precision optical components. That's things like lenses, laser glass slabs, mirrors, frequency conversion crystals, all of which amplify and guide NIF's 192 laser beams to hit a tiny target inside the 10 meter target chamber. Continuous research and development have put these optics at the cutting edge of material science and technology, and they play a crucial role in raising the laser's energy and power thresholds, which in itself are essential for research into complex nuclear interactions like nuclear fusion. So even though breaking an energy record is really cool, the megajoule accomplishment is about way more than just a number. It's more about the incredible infrastructure and team of people that made it happen, and that will continue to make breakthroughs like this as NIF moves into the future. Which brings us to our sixth and final milestone, Happles. That stands for High Repetition Rate Advanced Petawatt Laser System. It's an entire petawatt laser system that LLNL designed, developed, and constructed in only 3 years, and then we disassembled it and shipped it overseas to the Eli Beamlines Research Center in the Czech Republic. And get this, the Nova petawatt system that we talked about earlier was able to shoot a petawatt pulse just once an hour, whereas Happles is capable of shooting a pulse at that same level 10 times a second. Peak power pulses like this allow a whole new level of access to fields like medical imaging, laboratory or tabletop astrophysics, cancer treatments, laser fusion, materials testing, and so much more. And Happles is just the beginning. It represents a whole new generation of high-energy, high-peak power laser systems that LLNL is developing, and it's representative of the international collaboration and partnerships that are going to be really important for the continued advancement of lasers worldwide. Because, as we've seen on our journey through time since the 60s, advancements in lasers aren't actually just about the lasers. Developments like NIF, like Happles, like petawatt capability, generate so much data that we now have to use specialized high-performance computing to analyze it all. We now use cutting-edge additive manufacturing techniques to create targets that don't take 6 months to fabricate. And the tools we use to image and measure the behavior caused by laser-target interactions have also been forced to advance in really cool ways. So lasers are exciting on their own for all of the reasons we've mentioned in this video, but also because of the ways they push us to advance all kinds of other technologies in a really diverse array of fields. Lasers are truly bringing science as a whole into the future. If you enjoyed this video, then subscribe to our channel for more videos just like this and check out the full Inside the Lab playlist here. What we just covered are a handful of the countless achievements in laser technology that the lab has really led the charge for. And LLNL will continue to push the boundaries of what lasers, and therefore computing, material science, and so much more, are truly capable of. So stay tuned. And if you have questions for us about lasers or how we use them, leave them for us in the comments. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.